It's here.
The trailer.
That's right. We're going to be taking a look at Disney's Big Hero 6.
And Frank Miller and Ava Green get all film noir with our own Diana Gitelman.
That's right. And we're giving away an autographed football from the film When the Game Stands Tall.
And it all starts
now. Hey everybody, welcome to the trailer. I am Yassir Lester.
And I'm Erin Gibson.
That's right. And Marvel has been killing it, right?
Oh, yeah.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Check.
The Avengers.
Check.
Thor, Iron Man. They kind of got the game on lock right now.
They do, and they're bringing their newest franchise. We can call it a franchise.
We'll say franchise. Yeah, absolutely. I think it would be smart.
Big Hero 6.
Big Hero 6.
It has a number in it. They got to franchise it.
Absolutely. It's Disney and Marvel kind of teaming up, even though they're the same company. To bring us their newest animated feature. Let's take a look at a clip from the trailer.
We're gonna need some upgrades.
A lunatic in a mask just tried to kill us.
How cool is that? I mean, it's scary, obviously, but how cool?
What's wrong with you?
Low battery.
You home, sweetie?
We jumped out a window.
Who's that?
We jumped out a window.
Okay, first of all, I want a robot now.
Yes, a balloon robot.
A balloon robot. I feel like he's made out of plastic. Like, I don't feel like you could pop him.
I mean, you can, though. There's the part where he, like, starts spewing air. They hit him with a needle. It's like actually.
They just put Fix-A-Flat in it.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah. It's actually a thing in it. So this is the first movie since 2009 that Disney has done that takes place in a real world setting. You know, they usually make up a place. This one kind of still kind of made up. It takes place in a city called San Francisco.
So yeah, America and Japan.
America and Japan.
Well,
together.
Okay, if that's true,
yes.
Then that makes this the fourth Disney movie to take place in Asia.
Okay.
Okay, do you know the other
four?
Three? Well, it's a technicality, but I'm going to
okay.
count it. So there's three others. Do you know what they
okay.
are?
Mulan.
Duh.
Mulan 2.
No. Okay, Aladdin.
Okay,
and
yes.
Jungle Book.
Jungle Book was Asia?
Mm-hmm.
How did I never... Makes so
where
sense.
Did you think it was? Because I bet it's the same place I thought it was.
South America.
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Well, anyway.
Well, I hope it...
We're going to have to wait until November 7th to see that.
In Regal.
In Regal Cinemas. But what you can see in Regal Cinemas this weekend, Sin City 2, A Dame to Kill For. That's why we sent our very own Diane Gitelman to sit down with the director, Robert Rodriguez, and some of the cast to chat about it. Let's take a look.
Blind man at a new moon could see that she was planning something. I was going to find out what it was. Diana, Regal Cinemas.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good.
You're cunning, aren't you?
Whoa. You have that look. It's quite scary. My character is pretty evil and she's using men to get what she wants. She's like the femme fatale.
This is a language I was familiar with.
Were you a fan of Mr. Miller's graphic novels?
So much so that I did some tests on how to turn it into a movie. I tracked him down, met him in a bar in New York, showed it to him, did anything I could to get him to say yes. He came down, I shot the whole opening of the movie on my own dime without getting the rights to it first, just to prove that it could be done.
A man with a vision is one I don't want to mess with.
The worlds that he creates in Sin City are incredible, and then any other graphic novel that he's touched, they're just so dark and complex.
She was talking characters again. I understood.
Am I gonna make you smile? I'm gonna pinch you.
You're looking for a smile?
Yeah, I'm looking for a
that
smile.
That kind of smile? She made me smile. She won this one. You know anything really low down in your guts you knew you were gonna have to pay for? Sin. Fucking sin. You ever sinned? She was hiding something. I was gonna figure out what it was.
I'm pretty afraid to do anything overtly sinful. I have this, like, Catholic upbringing that keeps me from doing stuff like that.
She talked about Catholic guilt. I got it. I was a Jew.
Have you guys ever done anything real bad?
feel bad? Like, in your guts, you knew I shouldn't be doing this, but you did it anyways.
Oh, yeah. We all got a little Sin City in us.
Is this movie about love, Frankie?
Yes, it is. All my stories are. They're about love and heroes. In Sin City, I get to explore the much darker sides of both.
And there are dark sides of both.
Go see Sin City, A Dame to Kill For, in 3D.
I wish I could talk like that all the time.
I would give up my freedom for you.
Oh, transition to the fact that we saw The Giver this weekend.
The Giver. Yeah. We saw The Giver.
This was way darker than I thought it was going to be, but I hadn't read the book.
Yes.
I have.
Huge fan of the book. It's one of the only things that, like, I give out as presents. Like, I'm like, you've never read The Giver? And then I'll just buy it for someone and make them read it.
You give The Giver? That's funny.
I'll say this. They took liberties.
But well, they have to. There's so much. I mean.
Exactly. And that's the problem. It's a very dense book. Though it's not long, it is very dense. There's a lot of stuff in there. So
every time,
I understand it.
Look, here's. I'll say this in defense of all of these movies.
Yeah.
I can't imagine what you would have to do to take, to adapt a book that has so many new rules.
Right.
And then explain that to somebody.
This
we're trying
is
to make a perfect world.
Right, exactly. It's
right.
A utopia.
And we're
it's a teen,
it
you know, diverging.
Divergent.
From that.
Yep.
Running from it through a maze. Maze Runner.
Yeah.
They're hungry.
Hunger Games. I thought the awakening sequences were really, really impressive.
It was a nice, it was a nice juxtaposition from like the black and white that you see for a majority of the movie.
And
you
know? A long time in the making. Jeff Bridges couldn't get this movie made for a long time until
Which
Hunger Games.
Which is crazy.
Yeah.
It was such a popular book. I mean, like, it was one of the things that, again, like, it was like one of those books that was like, everyone needs to read this. And so I thought for sure it would be the front runner to make, and then,
not
you know,
until Hunger Games. Yeah.
And Robert B. Weide, how do you say his last name? Weide? Weed?
Yes.
Robert B. Weed, who's like an executive producer of Curb Your Enthusiasm, like, co-wrote the screenplay.
Love it. I love everything.
Yes.
Hey, we have a giveaway this week.
Yes, we have a giveaway.
It's a football. You're a huge football fan.
Oh, my God. I go out there. I throw the pork skin.
Yep, you got it.
Just get out there. Throw laces in.
Laces in.
Laces
yeah.
in, no matter what. That's the one rule
that you
of
learned
football.
For Ace Ventura. Yeah,
yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
Jim Caviezel.
Yes. Jesus.
Jesus is
yeah.
in it. The new movie you mentioned earlier, When the Game Stands Still. Tall. Sorry.
When
Not When the Game Stands Still.
The Game Doesn't Stand
When
still.
It Stands Tall.
Also, the big homie Michael Chiklis is in When the Game Stands Tall.
Yeah, you're right.
And he is the best on-screen cop of all time. I don't care what you say. He was in The Shield. He's better than T.J. Hooker. He's better
bad.
Than Riggs. He's better than Murtaugh. He's better than Dunstan from Dunstan Checks In.
Agreed.
Who, okay, maybe not a cop, but he did some detective work in
that. And that counts for something.
Exactly. And Let's Be Cops is now in theaters, right?
Yeah.
So we said to ourselves, then out loud to one another, why don't we play a little punny review game? The punny headlines for this movie have been psychotic.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So we said, you know what? If we want to give away this When the Game Stands Tall autograph football, why don't we make a punny review game? Hashtag your own punny reviews at home. Subscribe to our channel. Leave them in the comments below. And that's how you enter to win. Easy, right?
That's so easy.
Okay.
Why don't you go first?
Can I go first?
Because you have the Chiklis haircut.
Slick. It's Michael Slick Les. Okay, I know it doesn't work. It doesn't matter. Okay, first one. Jake Johnson and Damon Wayans Jr. are partners in crime. Like, they're cops, so it's
yeah.
It doesn't matter. Okay. Second one. Calling all units, Let's Be Cops is inciting laugh riots.
Yeah.
Okay. Last pun. Very funny. Though this comedy is in uniform, it's not a uniform comedy.
Whoa, reversed it. Okay,
yeah.
You're mine. Don't forget to write your own punny reviews in the comments below and subscribe to win a football signed by Jesus and Michael Chiklis. What was his character in when he was a monster? Didn't he play a monster in a movie?
The Thing in Fantastic Four?
Yeah.
Yeah. Marvel.
Win a football from Jesus and The Thing by just writing your own punny review. Here are mine. These boys in blue will have you in stitches.
Don't like it.
Neither do I, so we're on the same team for that. Watch out, Jump Street. These cops are in hot pursuit.
Acceptable.
Thank you. Armed and dangerous. They got jokes, and they know how to use them.
Very long.
Thank you so much.
Doesn't
okay.
matter though, because I win. Yassir is the winner.
That's a shame.
Yassir is the
it's
winner.
A shame it's
I'm not looking back. No, I'm not looking back, because I won. If you want to win, win the Game Stand Tall Autograph Football by Jim Caviezel and Michael Chiklis. All you need to do is write your own punny reviews, hashtag them in the comments below. Subscribe to the channel. Just do that, too.
Just do that, we'll see you next week.
That's right. That's Erin Lester. I'm Yassir Gibson, and we'll see you next week on the trailer.
And you'll see my bouncing head on the trailer.